Hi guys, this is DC Pushpa from Vyas Medical Academy. Today I am going to explain you very interesting and very important topic of neat point of view, that is nothing but the fluid mechanics. First, fluid mechanics is differentiated into the two subgroups. These are the fluid statics and the hydrodynamics. The fluid statics is the study of the fluids at rest. These are of the four types: hydrostatic pressure, flotation, Pascal's law, and the Archimedes principle. And the hydrodynamics. Hydrodynamics is defined as the science of the moving fluids. These are of the two types: continuity equation and the Bernoulli theorem. First, the hydrostatic pressure. For finding the hydrostatic pressure, we just want to do a simple experiment. First, take some liquid in a tub. We can observe many layers of the water in it. The height and density of the water layers can be described as rho1 h1, rho2 h2, rho3 h3, so on rho n h n. When we take the strip of area dA, then the force applied by these layers dF is equal to PdA. Let it assume as the equation 1, and the pressure occurred by all the layers of the water is P is equal to rho G H1 plus rho2 G H2 plus so on rho N GY. From the equation 1 and 2 we get dF is equal to rho1 gh1 plus rho2 gh2 plus so on rho n gh n of dA. This is the force applied by the many layers of the hydrostatic force. This is the formula used to find the hydrostatic force of the many layers. Next, we just move on to the flotation. Have you observed a person floats on his back on the surface area? Then the apparent weight of the person is zero. Here, first we just want to learn the laws of the flotation. Here, the laws of the flotation includes when the density of the water is heavier than the density of the solid, then the solid will float on the liquid. When the density of the liquid is more than the density of the solid, then the solid is sink in the liquid. When the density of the water and the density of the liquid are equal, then it maintains the constant equilibrium. The best example for the flotation is the U-tube. Let us discuss an example which is given in the previous examination of the NEET 2017. Let us consider the U-tube of 2 inches open to the atmospheric pressure. Let us pour the water on one side of the U-tube of 60 mm and other side the immiscible liquid like oil of 10 millimeters above the level of the liquid layer. Here 0.8 determines the level of the oil and the point B is the differentiates the oil and the liquid, and point C determines the level of the water. Here we just want to find the density of the liquid in this problem. The formula used is rho1 gh1 is equal to rho2 gh2. Here rho1 is considered as the density of the oil and g is constant for the both oil and the liquid water, and the height of the oil is given as the 140 millimeters. As we convert into the meters, we get 140 into 10 power minus 3 meters, and the height of the water is given as the 130 millimeters. As we convert into the meters, we get 130 into 10 power minus 3 meters. Then the rho1 is equals to 130 by 140 into 10 cube. The final answer we get is 928 kilogram per meter cube. In the flotation, let us discuss some important formulas. Next, we just move on to the next topic, Pascal's law. Pascal's law is determined as when the pressure applied at some part of the liquid is transferred to the total liquid. This is known as the Pascal's law. The best example for the Pascal's law is the hydraulic lift. The hydraulic lift is used for the washing of the cars. The hydraulic lift is based on the Pascal's law. It is the main principle of the hydraulic lift is lifting of the heavier objects by using the smaller heads. Here A object of the area A1 is used to the lift the object of the area A2. The force applied by the smaller object is F1 and the force applied by the bigger object is the F2. F is already we know that the force is equal to mass into the acceleration. So we consider as the small m into A and F2 is the capital M into A. The equation is F1 by A1 equals to F2 by A2. So as the A get cancelled, we get the final equation as small m by A1 equals to capital M by A2. Next, we want to discuss some of the important definitions of the Pascal's law, that are the density, relative density and pressure. Density is defined as the mass per the unit volume, and the units of the density is kilogram per the meter cube. And relative density is defined as the mass of the object in air by the mass of the object in water. And the next, pressure is defined as the mass per the force. Pressure is defined as the force applied per the unit area. Let us discuss an application on the pressure. First, take the four containers of different shapes and different areas. Pour the same quantity of the liquid in the four containers. Here we observe that the level of the water is same in the four containers as the shapes are different. But the pressure applied by the four containers is same. Next, we just move on to our next topic, Archimedes' principle. Archimedes' principle states that when an object is partially or fully immersed in the liquid, the weight of the object is determined as the amount of the water overflown. Here let us consider an object which is dipped into the liquid. The downward force acting on the upper surface is assumed as F1 and the upward force acting on the lower surface is assumed as the F2. Here the downward force acting on the upper surface F1 is equal to rho g F1 of A and the upward force on the lower surface F2 is equal to rho g H2 of A. The resultant upward force F is equal to F2 minus F1. Here by subtracting this we get rho g of H2 minus H1 of A. Finally we get as the height of the liquid is equal, then F is equal to rho g h of A. Here mass of the liquid into gravitational force, F is equal. Next, we just move on to our next topic, hydrodynamics. As I said before, the hydrodynamics is the study of the flowing fluids. These are of the two types, continuity equation and the Bernoulli's theorem. First, the continuity equation. Guys, have you observed water flown into a pipe? This is due to the continuity equation. Let us consider a pipe of the area A, of one side the area A1 and the other side the area A2. And the velocity of the water going inside is V1 and the velocity of the water coming out with the velocity V2. Here A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2 and AV is the constant. According to the continuity equation, the mass of the water getting in is equal to the mass of the water getting out. The conditions of the continuity equation is the liquid should be non-viscous and the liquid should be non-compressible and the liquid should be streamlined flow. Guys, have you observed the irrigation canals and why they are in V-shape? Because the velocity of the lower layers is high as the area decreases. The equation is A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Next, we just move on to the Bernoulli's theorem. Bernoulli's theorem is defined as the velocity of the equation of the Bernoulli's theorem is P plus half rho V square plus rho G H is equal to constant. When we derive this, we can get P1 plus half rho V1 square plus rho G H is equal to P2 plus half rho V square plus rho G H. Rho g H2. The application of the Bernoulli's theorem is when the upthrust acting on the roof, the upthrust is known as the dynamic lift, and when we see the wing of the aeroplane, the upward thrust acting on the wing of the aeroplane, due to the shape of the wing of the aeroplane, The velocity of on the upper layers is more than the velocity of the down layer, velocity of the lower layers. This is known as the aerodynamic lift. Here F is equals to rho 1 minus rho 2 of A. Next, the other application is when the wind blown onto the spinning ball, then the ball will just move upwards. This is known as the Magnus effect. Here the upward force, the upward pressure is P1 is equals to V1 plus V2, and the downward pressure is P1 is equals to V1 minus V2. Next, the next topic is types of the flow. There are the three types of the flow mentioned in this lesson. Those are laminar flow, streamline flow and the turbulent flow. Here laminar flow. Laminar flow, the velocity of all the layers is same at any point. This is known as the laminar flow and the streamline flow. The velocity of all the layers are same but at a particular point. This is the streamline flow. And turbulent flow. The velocity of these layers are different and these are in zigzag manner. This is known as the turbulent flow. Next, we just move on to our next topic, critical velocity. Critical velocity. The velocity which changes from the streamline flow to the turbulent flow, it is known as the critical velocity. And here, the equation of the critical velocity is Vc is equals to R eta by C into D. Here R is the Reynolds number and eta is the efficiency and D is the diameter of the object. Here, when the Reynolds number is less than the 2000, it can be considered as the streamline flow, and Reynolds number is greater than the 2000, it is given as the turbulent flow. Guys, hope all of you understand my topic. All the best for your NEET examination from the Vyas Medical Academy.